Hey Slayers, and welcome to What Made This So Good? What Made This Game So Good? A series where we take a look at game, multiple games in a series, and decide what made this game so good. Now, I know it's been a while since I made an episode of this, I think last one being Super Hang-On, and if I'm being honest, I kind of just forgot about this series, although from the view, I went back and I saw it, and it seems a lot of people did enjoy that series, so I'm bringing it back here. And today we're going to be looking at Vector Man. If you have a Sega series that you would like me to look at covering this series, be sure to let me know. It could be anything. Golden Axe, Super Hang-On. Well, I did cover Gold, and I think I previously covered Golden Axe and Super Hang-On and Columns. Golden Axe, Columns, and Super Hang-On are the previous series I covered. But I'll plan on covering stuff like Puyo Puyo, even Sonic the Hedgehog at some point. So all you Sonic fans, you know what I'm saying? We'll look at that. And when I say Sonic the Hedgehog, I mean the classic series. And the first three games, not and CD and 32X, maybe. I mean, Knuckles Chaotix, maybe. But anyway, yeah, we're going to get right into here with Vector Man, and we're going to be determining today what made Vector Man so good. And one of the first things I'm going to go ahead and tell you made Vector Man so good, this right here. I love this, how you get to play around on a Sega screen. I always thought it looked so freaking cool, and with widescreen, it looks even better. So that's one of the coolest things I love about Sega is how they always had like interactive Sega screens. That's just always been super cool to me. And I love this screen too. So this game was a 1995 Sega Genesis release. And for anyone who knows, yes, that is a very, oops. Anyone who knows, that is a very late release for Sega. At least on the Sega Genesis anyway. There was a, you know, we had a lot of games coming out during that era. And basically the story is, it's 2049 and the Earth's cities, forests, and ice caps are fouled with toxic sludge. Humanity has escaped to stars, leaving mechanical ore bots to clean up. See, we're smart. We're humans are smart. You know what I'm saying? We laughed. We were like, nah, dude, we've got to get out of here. But anyway, yeah, we can start the game now. Now, the game, the thing about this game is the difficulty is a little bit out there, I guess you can say. But both of these titles are extremely fun titles, both Vector Man 1 and 2. And I think the best part about them is they play so well and they're so familiar. I guess you can call them, I don't know what you would call these. I would say platformers. Other people might disagree since you have a weapon, a projectile weapon. And I mean, these pre-rendered graphics on both of these games here, are you going to see in a second, are just so great. They look awesome, like, honestly. For 1995 on a Sega Genesis, this is like PlayStation Sega Saturn 2D right here. This game looks great, like, honestly. It looks 100% awesome. And I mean, just for reference here, give me a second. Just for some reference here, look at those flags, dude. Look at the flags. They look 3D, and I pointed this out in my actual Vector Man video. I did do, but I did do a video on this as a whole, and if you want to go ahead and see that, it's available up on YouTube. You know, you can go check that out. It was a full-on video on this game and everything about this game. And I think that video was really good, but I never truly did one on Vector Man 2. So I guess you can count this as also like a review of Vector Man 2 if you want to. I don't count it as that because I might give it its standalone review one day and might just leave this one for the history books as like what made the series so good. But I mean, first off, this is one of the things that made the series so good. I mean, Donkey Kong Country didn't even look as good as this, at least to me. I mean, we're talking about years old hardware at this point. It's 1995. The Genesis came out in 89. And it was producing games like this still on what can be considered early PlayStation level, early Sega Saturn level. Like, honestly, the 3D here is amazing. And who, Blue Sky Software, I commend them for their hard work and dedication to making this game. In fact, there's an interesting story about this game, but I think I'll save that for Sega history. But essentially, as a basic rundown, the story goes that Blue Sky eventually later on approached Sega again about making a game in 2001, where Sega said they were making the one with another company, and the game never ended up coming out. But we'll save that, like I said, we'll save that for another time, particularly Sega history, because I think it's an interesting story that needs to be told. And we can go ahead and switch on to Vector Man 2 now. If I could just click it, there we go. And no interactive Sega screen this time, so I kind of don't like that. And this was a 1996 Genesis release. So we're in 96 now, you know what I'm saying? this game, we're already so deep into the Saturn lifetime. This might as well have, this can be considered one of the final releases for the Sega Genesis. We're talking 96, so this is one of the final releases here. The difficulty can be on cool, lame, wicked. Wicked is hard, lame is easy, and cool is, you know, medium. We'll keep it on, definitely keep it on cool, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, we have sound effects on, music on, you know. We can, C button to jump, content. Yeah, we can go ahead and start here. And I mean, just look at this cutscene as just like a little demonstration. Look at this ship. This ship is literally 3D, dude. Look at this. This cutscene looks freaking awesome. Look, we're literally full 3D right here. This is 96. A Genesis from 89 doing this in 96. I mean, honestly, dude. The Genesis, if they would have kept this type of thing up, I could have seen the Genesis still being supported and still receiving lower-end 32-bit ports. Like, honestly, this looks really good. No Sega CD, no 32X. Plus, the Genesis was still in high demand. These games were still selling well. As you can see, this plays so much like the first one, but it still has that same great techno music. The music in both of these games are really good. The music here is like full-on techno, like dance music, and it sounds really good here. The difficulty, like I said, on both of these games can be a little bit annoying from time to time, but once you get used to it, you get used to it. There we go. Cool. Beat the first level, and just the graphics again. The graphics are just so beautiful. Like I said, this puts Donkey Kong Country to shame. I mean, look at this. Look, Vector Man looks even more 3D than he looked the first time. They really went out and re-improved the graphics. Look at the shadows in this game, just the darkness. It looks freaking awesome. And then the first level is a maze, which is, you know, that is what it is. I don't like the fact that it's a maze, but yes, it is a maze. I mean, and the characters are pretty freaking huge. He has voice clips. You can hear him talking. He says stuff like, "I'll take that," and things like that. Ooh, dude. There we go. And see, you even collect these little things as like your currency or points, I guess. And you can find power-ups throughout the level, and just definitely both of these games, I'm going to go ahead and give them a 10 out of 10. You need to play. Vector Man is on the need to play list. It's Sega Genesis classic titles. Although, like I said, it came out in the later bit of the Sega Genesis life cycle. It is still remembered fondly by lots of Sega fans, including me, as a classic Genesis title, including Sega, as you know, they still release this on every Genesis collection under the sun. Even the at-game systems this gets released on. So, you know, Sega looks at this pretty fondly, even though, and maybe, who knows, maybe one day we can hope for a new Vector Man game. I don't know about you, but I think that'd be pretty sweet. I would love to see it, and I would love to personally play that. It sounds like it would be a blast to play a new Vector Man game here in 2020. What would it look like? It would probably be in 3D now. The voice clips are super clear, dude. The difficulty is not too hard. I'd say you have a perfect recipe for good games. So anyway, that's what made Vector Man 1, 2, the Vector Man series as a whole is so good. There might be some titles I'm missing here, but for all I know, there's only Genesis titles of Vector Man 1 and 2. Like I said, there will be a Sega history video on this at some point next year when we return for Season 2. But as of right now, if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to help us reach 200 subscribers. It would be really awesome. Make sure you share this video with your friends to become a Super Slayer. I've been the world's coolest Sega enthusiast, Sega Slayer 64. And until next time, have a good one, Slayers.